Hello and welcome. My name is Mark, and in this video, we will go through federating the Cloud Portal's IFS, or Infor Federation Services, federated hub to the Azure AD Identity Provider. This will include configuring authentication and authorization to the Infor Cloud Suite. Businesses may want to integrate with Microsoft's Azure AD as an identity provider because this will enable single sign-on to be used, and that will assist with account management using your corporate sign-on credentials. Here is a diagram showing the high-level architecture of what will take place, federating the Infor Cloud Identity Provider and Azure AD. There is also an option to automate user provisioning using SCIM or System for Cross-Domain Identity Management. This will be covered in future videos. Let's get started. Open a browser and navigate to the Infor Cloud Portal. Log on to the Cloud Portal with an admin cloud identity account. Once in the Cloud Portal, click the person icon in the upper right-hand corner and choose User Management. If you do not have the User Management link, you will need the IFS Application Admin and User Admin security roles assigned to your user account. In the User's menu selector, expand Security Administration and select Federated Security. Select Federated Security again. Click the plus button to add a new item. If not already checked, select the box for SAML 2.0 enabled and validate authentication with Infor STS or Infor Security Token Service is selected. Infor STS is an access management solution that provides security access to Infor web applications. The Infor STS option should be enabled by default. Export the Infor STS metadata. Scroll down to the service provider information. Select and locate the view button and click it. Select the Export SAML metadata link from the service provider information window. Once downloaded, click Cancel. You will use this downloaded metadata file to build the Azure AD Enterprise app. You will now create the Enterprise app in Azure AD. Access the Azure portal. Select Azure Active Directory under the Azure Services. In the Manage section, select Enterprise Applications. Click on the New Application button to create a new Enterprise app. In the Browse Azure AD Gallery section, enter Infor in the Search Application box and select the Infor Cloud Suite Gallery. Provide a name for the Enterprise app. We recommend putting the tenant name somewhere in the name field, like Infor Cloud Suite Dem. Then click Create. Once created, select Single Sign-On under the Manage section and select SAML. You will now upload the metadata file that was downloaded from the Cloud Tenant. Click the Upload Metadata File button. Browse and select the service provider SAML metadata file from the Cloud Tenant and click Add. This will update the basic SAML configuration with the tenant Infor STS cloud details. Click the Save button. Under the SAML Certificates section, select the download link next to the Federation Metadata XML. This metadata file will be used to complete the federation on the Cloud Tenant. You will need to add users and/or groups to the Enterprise app for Azure accounts you want to have access to the tenant. Select Users and Groups under the Manage section and click the Add Users/Groups button. Under Users and Groups, select the non-selected link and search for accounts to add. Click on the Azure accounts you want to have access to the tenant. Then click the Select button. You will then click the Assign button. Note that these accounts will need to be added to the Cloud Portal's User Management Identity Store. Now you can complete the Cloud Portal federation with Azure. Return to the Cloud Portal's Federation Security section and click the From File button. Browse and select the Infor Cloud Suite XML file you exported from Azure, and then click Import. You will notice the Azure Identity Provider information will be updated in the Tenant Federation fields. Enter a display name for your Azure Federation. An example would be Azure. Note the name will be displayed on the Home Realm screen once the federation is complete. Click the Save button. Now that the federation is saved, click the back arrow beside Federated Security to return to the Security Administration section. Under Security Administration, select Authentication URL Options. Click the box for Allow User to Choose Authentication Mode and click Save. This will enable the Azure icon to be displayed on the Home Realm screen. It is time to test the authentication to the cloud portal. Open an incognito or in private browser and navigate to the cloud portal. On the Home Realm screen, you should now see an Azure selection. Select the Azure button. Under Sign In, supply the Azure account information and click Next. Supply a password. If you get the Stay Signed In page, click No. Otherwise, continue. After authentication, the account will be authorized for access and the cloud portal will be presented. This concludes this presentation of the Identity and Access Management Cloud Portal Federation to the Azure AD Identity Provider. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe to get notified when new videos are available.